Hi students, today we are going to learn about one of the important topic in our syllabus. So let us see what is the topic and how it is important in our day-to-day life. So let us see, in your surroundings you are able to observe different kinds of living forms. In your surroundings you are able to observe different kinds of living forms. Okay, so that living forms are varied from one to another, means each and every organism is not having similarities. Some of them are very tall, some of them are very short, some of them are very big, some of them are small. Color variation may present, structurally they are different, shape wise they are different. Like that, different kinds of variations you will observe in your surroundings. Are you able to identify those organisms by seeing their external features? For example, one organism came in front of you on road. Are you able to identify what kind of organism it is? Yes, of course. Obviously, we are able to identify what kind of organism it is. It is a dog, it's a cow, it's a buffalo. Like that, we are able to identify different kinds of organisms, because of seeing their features, how those organisms got those features, the organisms will get from the parents. So the features what we will observe externally, those features organism will get from the parent. So some of the traits or the characters organism will get from the parent, and parent also able to pass some of the features from them to the offspring. Offspring in the sense new generation. Parent also transfer some of the characters to their next generation. So this process we call it as heredity. Heredity, transfer of heritable traits from parent to offspring. Here I mentioned a word, progeny. Progeny, what is meant by progeny? Progeny in the sense the new organism, younger one, what it come from the parent. So parent pass so many types of features, characters, traits to the new generation. So such a process we call it as heredity. So heredity is very important to pass several kinds of features from parent to offspring, and offspring able to get different kinds of features from the parent. How is it possible? That is through heredity. So this is our lesson, heredity. And now let us see what we will read in this chapter. What are the different topics we will observe in the chapter? But before that, once again you see the meaning and definition for heredity on screen. So here it is, the slide, heredity. So the passing of traits from parent to offspring. Trait indicate character, feature. Not all types of characters and features, but most of them it will pass from one to another, from parent to offspring. Such a kind of process we call it as heredity. That may be from mother to child, from father to child. So two parents involved in the production of a new generation. So that new generation will get both the characteristic features of both the traits of mother and father. That is nothing but we call it as heredity. Now in this heredity chapter, let us know about different aspects. So what are those aspects? Here see on screen. We will read about variation, traits, evolution. And in the variation, two types again, environmental variations, genetic variations. Environmental variations, genetic variations, two types of variations. Like the traits also. See, traits also two types. What are those? Acquired traits, inherited traits. Again, in the inherited traits, we will see the rules for inheritance of traits set by Mendel, Gregor Mendel. So he conducted several experiments on this heredity, inheritance, and he proposed three important laws: law of dominance, law of segregation, law of independence. Rules for inheritance traits. In that, Mendel proposed three important laws: dominance, segregation, and independent assortment, we call it as. And in this chapter only, we will read about sex determination also, and artificial and natural sex determinations also. So several topics are there in this heredity. It is one of the very important chapter in our syllabus. So variations means so many differences we will observe from one organism to another organism. How these will come, that it indicates variation. Traits. Traits means a characteristic features. So how these characters, features, that it transfer from parent to offspring. Trait indicates several features. Evolution means a development, sequential and gradual changes which takes place in the primitive organisms. Because of this gradual changes, organism shows development. Organism shows a development. That is, we call it as evolution. So in the variation, environmental variations and genetical variations, two types are there. Environmental variations are come from different kinds of climatical conditions and the chemicals which are present. And it may, in this education also involves, diet also involves. So through the environment, what kind of changes organism will get, that it indicates environmental variation. Genetic variation in the sense, in the organism's body, genes shows several types of changes. Genetic variation occurs and mutation occurs, recombination occurs, that it gives several types of changes. So that it indicates genetic variation. Next, in the traits, acquired traits, acquired characters. How we will get this acquired characters? We will get this one individually. This we won't get from the parent. So our way of language, our education, our art, each and everything through practice, through learning, what we will get, those all are the acquired traits. About all these segments we will read again, but what I want to convey to you, these all are the important topics we need to read in this heredity chapter. Like that, inherited traits from parent to offspring. Next, in this inherited traits only, so rules of inherited traits, that it is set by Mendel. So Gregor Mendel, considered as father of genetics, he conducted several experiments on genes. And he concluded and proposed several laws regarding to this genetics. So what he said three important laws, very, very important. We need to discuss this one later. Dominance, segregation, and independent assortment. And finally, sex determination, natural and artificial sex determination also we need to read in this chapter. So these are the different areas we need to cover in this lesson. So now let us come towards to the keywords. So keywords. So different important terms we will read in this chapter. Different important terms. Some terms at the time of topic only you are able to understand. Such a kind of terms here I didn't take. So the terms which one is essential to each and every topic, such a kind of few keywords here I want to explain. So the first one is variation. So variation means changes. So also different kinds of changes we will observe in this variation. So what is the definition for this variation? See on screen. So variation, see children, here differences between living things of the same species. What is meant by same species? Same type of organisms. In same type of organisms also you are able to observe lot of differences. Those differences we call it as variation. So what kind of features will comes, what kind of differences we will observe in the body? So see here, your classmates may have different, your classmates all are humans, all are same age group children, but you all are not looks in a similar way. Several variations are present in between you people. What are those variations? Eye color. So the people and the iris, it's having a color. That color is varied from one child to another. Some may have black, some may have brown, and some may have honey color, some may have blue color also. So such a kind of variation. Hair color, hair also is having different colors. Black shade you are able to observe, but in that several differences are present. And some boys and some will be girls. Gender variation it will be present. Male, female, two are different structural wise. So such a kind of difference are also comes under variation. Some will be tall, some will be short. So some may be very too long and some may be very dwarf. So such a kind of differences, same class, a small area it is, few children only present. In that few children only we are able to see such a kind of vast, huge variations we observe. So that it indicates variation, nothing but differences between living things of the same species. Now let us see another important word in our keywords, that is evolution. Evolution, gradual change over a period of time is called evolution. First if you observe, that is ape, like a gorilla and chimpanzee, such a kind of structure is present. But slowly, gradually, it won't happens all of suddenly. All of suddenly you can't see any kind of drastic change. So evolution indicates gradual change over a period of time. It takes a lot of time. Evolution won't possible within 1 year, within 2 years, or within a decade. It may take so many years of time. So slowly the organism shows changes and gradually it develops and reaches to the final stage. This process is called it as evolution. So next, come back to the board here. The next important term word, it is alleles. A new term to you people, alleles. So this allele is closely related with these two terms. What it is? One is chromosome and second one is gene. Now first of all we will start with the chromosome. What is meant by chromosome? What is meant by chromosome? Where it is present? How it looks like? In the previous chapter only we got the perfect information regarding to this chromosome. So in each and every cell, in a eukaryotic cell, nucleus present. In the nucleus, nucleolus present, a dark stained body, nucleolus present. In the nucleolus, nucleic acids are present, DNA, RNA, two types of nucleic acids, ribonucleic acid, deoxyribonucleic acid, DNA, nucleic acid. This nucleic acid is it forms like a long thread-like structure, okay, long thread-like structure called as chromatin, When the cell starts to divide, this chromatin condenses and forms specific structures. those structures we call it as chromosomes. Chromosomes. So these chromosomes are having specific descriptive units for each and every character to exhibit, to represent each and every character. Specific units are present. That specific units we call it as genes. Genes. Are you following me? So nucleic acid forms a long thread-like structure. It is called it as chromatin. When cell starts to divide, this chromatin condenses and comes in the way of specific structure that is called it as chromosome. So this chromosome is having specific descriptive unit, a segment it is. Segment of nucleic acid we call it as gene. Okay, what is the relationship here in between gene and a allele? Each gene is having two alleles in a human body. Each gene is having two alleles. So allele is a different version of gene. Allele is a different version of gene. To exhibit any kind of character, two factors are responsible. That two factors we call it as alleles. Each gene is having certain two alleles. These alleles are responsible for exhibition of representing of different characteristic features. So in a human, each gene is have two alleles. Understand, children? So that is meant by allele. Now let us see on screen. Allele. Alleles are different forms of same gene. Gene one only. That it exhibit one character only. But that one character is having two different forms. For example, a person. Height is the factor. It's a character, height. Okay, that height always may not be tall. Sometimes it will be short. So for tall one allele is responsible, for short one allele is responsible. Which one will dominate, that one exhibits outside. In these two alleles, which one is dominates, that one will exhibit. That is the dominant one. Okay, so like that, gene and allele and chromosomes are having lot of importance in the exhibition of characters. It will represent the characters in our body. Next, come towards another important two keywords, homozygous, heterozygous. Homo, same. Hetero, different. Homozygous, heterozygous. If the two alleles are same, if those two are exhibit the same character, it's a homozygous. If the two alleles are represents two different forms, that it is heterozygous. Heterozygous. Now this one also clearly you will see on screen. Homozygous and heterozygous. See children, two alleles are present. Two alleles are same. Means two are having same feature. But the heterozygous, you see, one allele is different with another allele. Means for example, heterozygous, now only I said for exhibition of one character, two alleles are responsible. If the character is height, capital B indicates the tallness, small b indicates the dwarfness, means shortness. But how the character come outside, which one will dominate in these two? That only exhibits outside. Which one will dominate? The tall one dominates. So finally the exhibited character is tall. But the two alleles are different. Here the two alleles are same. So in which area you will see the two alleles in the same way, those two we considered as homozygous, and which are having two different features, that it is having heterozygous. So that's called heterozygous. So like this, homozygous and heterozygous, these two terms frequently we will see in this lesson. So before we are entering into the topic, we must and should know the meaning of these two terms especially. Now again, come back, that it is a natural selection. Natural selection. Natural selection. Nature only selects. Which one will select here? Nature only select. You can't involve in this. Nature only selects. What the nature will select? Which is suitable to the organism to survive in any kind of particular environment. What kind of features or helps to the organism, that is selected by nature. Are you following me? So organism survive is very important. To survive in particular environmental conditions, which kind of features helps to the organism, those only present in the organism body, remaining or eliminates. Which one will eliminates? Nature only eliminates. So such a kind of process we call it as natural selection. So see here again on screen regarding to natural selection. Selection of species by the nature to survive or perish. So not only a feature, even the species also. For example, in a forest, two types of deer are there. One is able to run very fast, but one is unable to run that much fast. So which one is eaten by the predator? Which one is eaten by the tigers and lions? Which one unable to run fast? That one eaten by the predators. So which one eliminates finally? Which one is unable to run? That one eliminates finally. Which one will survive? Which one is able to run fast? That one will survive. Who selected this one? Nature only selects. So such a kind of way natural selection helps for the surviving of the organism. If the organism is not suitable to the environment, if the organism is unfit to get the food material from the environment, if it is unable to survive, then that it is eliminated from the atmosphere is done by nature only. So such a process we call it as natural selection. Next come towards to another important term, that is genetics. Genetics. What is meant by genetics? Genetics means the study of genes. So the study of heritable traits, how it passes from one generation to another generation, from parent to offspring. That one this indicates. Genetics. Study of heritable traits, how it transforms from parent to progeny, from one generation to another generation. Here again, two terms, two important terms, we need to know the difference, that it is heredity and inheritance. Both are looking similar, but a slight variation is present in between these two terms, heredity and inheritance. What is meant by heredity? Transfer of traits from parent to progeny, heredity. Inheritance means transfer of features from one generation to another generation, from your grandparents to the means small children, from ancestors to generation, this one indicates inheritance. Transfer of heritable traits from one generation to another generation is called inheritance. But the transfer of heritable traits from parent to progeny we considered as heredity. So that is the difference in between heredity and inheritance. So these are the important keywords: variation, evolution, alleles, chromosomes, gene, homozygous, heterozygous, natural selection, and genetics. So these are some of the important terms in our topic. Now let us enter into the first topic in our lesson, that it is variations. That only first topic, variations. Already I said to you what is meant by variation. What is meant by variation? Recall once again on screen with a slide. What is meant by variation? Difference between living things of the same species is called variation. So different kinds of differences we will observe in different organisms of the same species. Now, once see the characters, how the character variation means in each and every organism, we won't see same kind of characters. Some new characters will produce. Some new characters arrives in the organism's body that we won't see in the parents, that we won't see in the grandparents also. How these are possible? These are also some kind of variation helps for a new species formation also sometimes. These variations are must and should. Without variation, organism can't survive in the environment. So, to adjust in the environmental condition, always organism shows some modifications. That modifications we considered as variations. These only must and should for the survivability of the organism. If organism can't show variation, it will extinct from the atmosphere. It will eliminate from that area. So, that's why variations play key role in the formation of new characteristic features in the organism's body. This one helps for evolution also. So, when these changes are continuous and gradual, then only we will see evolution also. Through the evolution, we are able to see sometime a new species. A new organism forms through this evolution. Evolution based on variation. So, when there is a variation, then only we will see the gradual development called as evolution. When the evolution we will observe, then after some time we may see some new species also. So, variation is not only a small difference, it may form sometimes a new species also, like from ape to human being. Ape is very different organism, structural wise, color wise. So, but human is totally different. How human came? From the ape only. But it not happened suddenly. So, several variations first it occurs. After gradually these changes forms a new species. It shows evolution. So, like this, variations are very, very important. Now, this variation, once you try to observe in your surroundings, how it will be in your class, in your house, how it will be, once see, with another slide, see here, variations, character, activity, it is actually children in your textbook, character, in me, in mother and father, and in grandparents. So, what is the character, color of eye? What is the color of eye in your body? It's black color. What is about your mother and father? It's also black. What's about your grandmother? Also black. How you got this character, black color of eye? That it came from your parents and grandparents. And type of nose. In you, it's long. In your mother and father also long. But in your grandparents, it will be short. And color of hair, so black color, you got black color, so your parents and grandparents are also having similar way black color hair. So, that character only you got through heredity. Type of hair, you have curly hair, your parents are also having curly, but your grandparents are have straight. Now, once you check it out this entire table, what characters you have, that it may come either from your parent or it may come from your grandparent. A new variety of the character, of course, some new characters are also generates, but most of them if you observe, those are related with either your parent or it may match with your grandparent. So, this indicates we have lot of similarities in our family members. So, in our family members, you are able to see so many similarities because the same genes it transfers from grandparents to parents and parents to offspring. But if you compare yourself with your classmates, see here. So, your friends. So, here I mentioned several names, not only those of course. So, one person is having color of skin, black. Earlobes, end of the ear. What it is in two types, free earlobe attached. means from your side of the jaw, in some members it will be attaches, but in some members it will be free. So in Ravi, such a kind of ear lobe is free. Making on inner side of thumb, so it is round. Thumb inner side it is round. Length of forehead, it's a very broad. Color of eye, blue. So any other features, if you observed hair, nose, face features also, we are able to mention. Next, another friend. If you observe the same features in your another friend, color of the skin may black, ear lobes are attached. Means Ravi is having one kind of nature and Sai is having another kind of nature. And the inner side of the thumb, it is conical. Length of the forehead, it is narrow. And color of the eye, it is black. You can't see any kind of match in between these two. At least, means especially, I think only in one area we are seeing the similarity, that is color of skin. Remaining all are different from one to another. Like that Ganesh, fair, color of the skin, he is very fair. And free, the ear lobe is free. And making on inner side of thumb, it is conical. Length of the forehead, also broad. And color of eye, it is black. But if you observe the hair, it is a curly, short nose, round face. So facial features, if you observe, such a kind of features are present in Ganesh. And Kartik, here why we are taking these many children, so many we are taking, but we can't match exactly with anyone. So that's why only here we are seeing different kinds of friends. Kartik, fair, ear lobes are free, and inner side of the thumb round, color of the eye black, but he is having straight hair, long nose, round face, etc. So if you observed, if you compare your characteristic feature with your friends, you can't match all these characters exactly with any one of your friend. Each and every one are having different kinds of features, because they got their features from their parents. Those are not related with us. So depend upon the variations, by seeing of these variations, you are able to understand how the traits are transforms from parents to offspring, from our older generation to younger generation, from our ancestors to our younger ones. So these one play key role, and these one will say to us how far these characters transfers from parents to offspring. So that's why variations play key role, and these are responsible, these are must and should to the organism to adjust in different kinds of environmental conditions. And these variations leads to evolution, that it forms sometimes a new species also. These variations we will observe in each and every organism of a same species also. All organisms may under in same species, but still we are able to see lot of differences. So such a kind of differences we considered as variations. So in this class we learn about all these children, means keywords, and about variations, how these are helps, and what is the importance of variation. Okay.